Well, let's get in trouble one last time before Santa Claus comes. Squire, by Fender, Precision Bass, something down there. But it's a PJ. And still got all the Peely stuff on it. And it's got, I'm not going to say, well, approaching sharp fret ends. We may as well kill that before it becomes what it shouldn't. Stay tuned. So I got the end of my ear chopped off today. I don't know if you can see that, right? Don't even get me going. That had to happen. But while it's still frozen, before I start squealing, oh man. When the surgeon guy stuck that needle into my ear, it was sort of like if someone took those and went, holy jeez. I didn't swear, but I did squeal. All right, anyway, enough of that. This will get better. Thank God this got done before Christmas. I would have been stuck with this forever. It was driving me nuts. Well, I'm already nuts, but it was making me more nuts. So, we have neck relief equaling, actually, not bad, really. It's usable. Thing's not all bent. You know, it's not a big banana. Like I said, back to the sharp fret ends. I know that. We've always come across that with these. And the other thing that probably will happen, but we'll see, when I set it up, the nut slots here aren't always cut deep enough and it plays not nicely. I have a quick look at the string height. So after that, nothing else matters. I guess I'm not putting new strings on it. I don't think there were any supplied, and I'm not going out into the Christmas shopping world looking for strings. So that's acceptable, five-ish. That's set way too low. That's at 3, so that would make it play like shit. And that one's set at 4, so they're all not the same. Okay, well, pop the strings off it. I'll look in the case. I don't think there's any new strings for this, but the, you know, it's a new guitar. Fix the fret ends with the weapon of choice. A great intelligent question I get asked very often about, what is the fret end file that you use? Well, you sort of got to use all of them. I hate to break the news to you, some are better for different jobs than others are. But the most important thing is to figure out what's actually sharp. So if the tang is hanging over and I put my finger here, see, it's not the tang, that's smooth here. But when I wrap my fingers around the frets, it's this, it's where they've beveled the fret and didn't really do a very nice job. Back to the files. The best one for that is this one from Stumac, which has the contour in it with two safe edges. I can probably do this without taking the strings off. I just loosen them, get them out of the way, and I'll just demonstrate that you really don't need any protection. But the other thing is, I want to polish all these anyway, so I'm going to pop the strings off. But I'm just showing, if you've got like a one sharp fret end bugging you, you don't need to take the strings off to kill that. That's the one for that. Then there's this guy, which will get you there, but it's a lot more strokes and a little more finesse. So we've got a sharp filey edge there and a safe edge there, and I would put the safe edge on the fingerboard and then rotate that gently towards the center
on both sides till I alleviate that little bit of burr that's been left behind. There's these that came from, wow, I thought that was a Stumac, really? But here, no. That one came from these guys. This is another little Stumac guy. This is sort of the same. We got a safe edge, we've got a round edge. But, like this one, that's not the one. This one, well, they're sort of, yes, but no. This one is designed to be the same width as the fret. So if that is hanging over with a little finesse, I can do that just like that, you know, just like that. But they're all a little different. Some are a little wider than others. Some work better for bass frets. Safe edge there. How does this one work? Safe edge there. So that would take me over in that direction. The round side, that's interesting. I never might want to look those up again. Anyway, this is the weapon of choice. I am going to peel the strings off it. And there's two of these. There's a wider one for bass frets. So I got this big honking fret eraser with a bit of a groove in it. I need to maybe dress that again. But I'll take that and go over everywhere. I took the ends off. And then we'll do all of them with all the fret erasers. Then we'll oil the fingerboard. Then we'll set it up. Like, if I can afford to have, a trained animal, train a cat to do this, maybe. Something like that. As I'm trying to make things better, I'm exposing their craftsmanship, which is a few marks in the fingerboard. But see, if you take the fret eraser and you go with the grain, you can actually get that stuff out of there. That's 1,000 grit fret eraser on rosewood. That worked great. These are pretty much shined up. Give her an earling and put it back together. That seems to look a lot better than it did a few minutes ago. We'll wind the strings back on it and make it play like a bass. Okay, the fret ends are fixed, and I'm not going to fault whoever made this, because for the amount of money this costs, that's why those aren't finished. I'm going to tune it up and let's set it up, I guess. I hope. Oh, back to something. There was a comment, I thought, that the neck is not finished on this. No, there is no finish on the neck, but there is sanding sealer on this neck. It's not raw wood. So whoever thought that this is raw wood, because if this was raw wood, and I put my dirty fingers on this once, twice, or even three times, or even if my hands are clean, this would all be stained by my fingers. And it's very, very perfectly smooth, but that is sanding sealer, guys. Sanding sealer. They seal it, and then they sand it. And that's all you get. We're tuned. Check that neck straightness again, which was good, and I did check the truss rod when I had the strings off it, just to make sure it spun, and it does. And it needs to spin just a little bit tighter, just a little bit, not much. I do my best to get a really good shot of what goes on in there. So the actual adjustment is hidden way back in there, and then there's that part of it that isn't part of it. So unless you look really closely, you could be fooled.
I get that in there, thinking that the first opening is where the wrench goes, and that's not it. It's hidden way back in there, and it's 4 mil. So don't be fooled.
Well, I did get it to adjust, but this is really tight. And I don't know, somebody made a comment in one of my other videos when I'm adjusting the truss rod and you hear it go click, or you hear it go make a snapping noise, right? That's not the nut. That's the truss rod moving against the channel in the neck, probably for the first time. This thing is uber freaking tight, boys. Really tight. But it's set. So if it doesn't move anymore, ever again, we're happy. I'll take that. Let's get the string height right. String me up height. What did I say I love? Five. Got him. 64 is at the 17th fret. Makes your life wonderful. It needs to come down a little bit. So, just making sure the saddles are all across, straight. And I'll roll with that. That one's good. This one's the one that's got to come up. Get out of here. And I think we're okay. Let's see if all the strings actually play. Right? That's when we end up with. Amazing. So, Barkin basement. Fret ends. And fret ends to the pickup height, and then we'll go down here because I know these aren't always right. Pickup height, intonation, and to the nuts. A little pickup height action too close, too far away. Okay. Too far away. Will it pop up? Stay tuned. Happy days. A little intonation check. And then down that end, which is another job, right? Why don't we make sound? Oh, there we go. That's a good thing. Usually I always get this right. Must be a machine that does it. Well, I see my reflection in the tuner. I almost scared myself. A little sharp on that D string. That up. Now down to the other end. The maximum I want to see at that first fret between the string and the first fret is 22 thousandths of an inch, right? See, too much. Close, very close. We're good probably on the treble side. Don't mind, that's me scratching the feeler gauge making static electricity. That one. Just have another quick look here. Sorry for the bad camera work. A string as well. Probably all of them. So let's just get the nut files out and fix that. And I will definitely
straighten anybody out that says all they need is a good setup. No. Doing short fret ends and filing nuts, that's not part of a setup. Setup is when everything works and you adjust what is there. That's a setup. I don't want to use that side. I take all the writing off it. It doesn't take much, but it really does make a lot of difference. Especially because most of the work you do is down at that end of the machine. That end's fixed up. Just got to revisit the string height again because we've lowered that. And that'll affect this, but that's why we do that last. And then we'll compensate accordingly. So these all just got to come up a tiny little amount. Just to make the difference for what I took off the other end. It is actually a triangle, if you're a mathematical person. Wake up. Dave Durth. Okay, that's 5. That's 5/64s. That's 5/64s. That's 5/64s. Oh, this isn't bad. I'd play it now. But, come on, find a hole, Dave. I'd play it now. Something came to me there. I always find this is sort of a waste of energy, really. Since you turn that one up, it takes over. Right? We got a bit of a blend. Both pickups up, it seems to suck away the volume. I'll watch. Right? So now, to me, that's useless. And like with all my bass playing all over the years, I've always left the volumes up wide open and maybe used the tone. Christmas, happy holidays, happy Hanukkah, happy everything, because that's what life's about, folks. What else? Just special thanks to everybody. All the links, there's stuff are below. I'll see y'all after the Christmas. It's coming up. Be safe, be good to each other. Cheers.